Okay guys, now I will teach you guys De La Riva guard pass. Actually, it's a De La Riva, we're gonna talk about actually when the person transition De La Riva to the health guard, and I'll be teach you guys how to pass, okay? Especially if your opponent like transition De La Riva to the deep half. It's a good transition. But awesome, it's a good pass. The way that I do the technique, it's really good because I'm controlling my opponent's leg. And I'll be share with you guys, especially in the De La Riva. Sometimes you're here, right? Sometimes I'm here, my opponent control the collar. Okay, and then most of the times, like some people, they use the hook right away, right? And then they make you like fall to your side. Okay, but let's say if you end up with this position here, I don't worry about break the grip on my collar. My goal is to control my opponent's pants this way. I'm controlling his leg. Okay. Now I believe he's not gonna sweep me. He's not gonna do like betting ball or stuff like that. Okay. But he can transition from the deep half because it's easy for him to underhook my leg. And he transition like to start sliding his body under here to transition from the deep half. Okay. If you guys see, I'm still controlling his pants. But right now, like this hand that I have on his pants, I will switch. Okay, I will slide my hand behind his top leg and I make this the same grip. I'll make this grip here. He's not gonna move his leg anymore because I'm trapping his bottom leg with my grip. Plus, I will trap his top leg with my forearm, you see? And it's hard for him to break my grip. Now what I'm gonna do is I will connect my right knee over his leg. The reason that I do that is because once I start using my point my knee over his leg, I will use his leg against his arm. I will trap like this, you see? And I'm still trapping his leg. He's not gonna come up anymore. If he try using his elbow to come up, he doesn't have enough angle because his foot still off the ground, plus my weight on top of him. Okay, now from here, I have this hand free. I will underhook his arm. Okay, once I underhook his arm, I stretch my leg. I want to make sure I don't stretch my leg behind my his back. I want to stretch my leg all the way out this way because now I can open up his elbow. Now I bring my heels down like this. Okay, from here. I don't want to cross face of him. My arm go over the shoulder and I grab behind his back. Now I will use my elbow to control his neck and my knee go right in front of his belly. Now I can start to clear my foot and I'll end up in the side control. Like this. Okay, let's see. We here. Make me fall, I can pull his pants. There I go. And I switch the grip right away. I switch his transition from the deep half, I switch my grip. The hand on top go behind his leg, and I grab the bottom leg. Now I change my angle. I sit on top of him. I pull the bottom leg to me. I underhook the arm. Now I stretch my leg this way. Once I let it go the pants, my arm go over here. I want to keep my weight on the opposite side of his body. I stretch my leg. Okay, once I stretch my leg, I change my angle. Because once I do that, I will take his shoulder off the ground. That way I can make my grip behind his back. So I close the elbow. Now I start sliding my knee. Start to pass my knee in front of his belly. And then I'll end up in the side control.
Okay. Yeah, that's the position that I like as well. Once the person transitions from the deep half. And yeah, hope you guys enjoy.